obviously it's horrifying. Anytime a crime like this is committed, people lose their lives. What we've learned over the last year, 2 years, is that it's really important to let all the facts come out before we start opining about public policy. We don't know all the facts behind this yet. There's a press conference happening here soon that will detail more. We've seen some press reports that this was a troubled individual, which calls to question how he could have been accepted as a correction officer trainee just a month ago or late December by the state of Florida. How he acquired that gun, clearly it doesn't seem to be someone that has a criminal background, so would have passed the background check. So these are complicated issues that unfortunately all are very different from each other. But we should wait to know the facts. If there is something that emerges from this that there could be a federal response to, I would be open to it. I think everyone's against criminal acts, particularly those that end in loss of life.